Well, I started out back when I was 15 with the Minnesota State Guard because they wouldn't let me enlist because I was too young. And I went to summer camp twice with the State Guard up in Minnesota. And I really loved the military and the way people acted and treated everybody equal. And it was interesting. And that's what really got me motivated to stay with it and try and be the same kind of a person. I think the most fun was everybody that was bombing out on us on the gas mask. And the way they acted like man, they were going to die. And it never bothered me because I'd gone through it before with the National Guard, so I hardly ever wore a mask. Late 51, and then went back in 52 for 13 months. With your platoon sergeant, you gotta keep going to keep the men whole, going with you on your platoon. And I guess from my early years when with the National Guard and then joining the police department in St. Paul as a boxer, kept me going. Oh yes, we were in Pickle Metals cold weather training. I had a 76 count myself and unit trying to get special training. That night we were up in the mountains. It starts snowing. So we got everybody going because they were trying to keep their shelter halves and everything from caving in with the snow on it. One man had to stay out and brush snow all night long, the other one would sleep. So finally he said, let's go. We're gonna move down into the valley and get a little bail from the snow. When we got down there, it was around 6 in the morning. It was getting daylight already. And everybody's complaining, they're soaking wet. Got all 75 of them out there. Said, men, we're going to build 3 igloos. Where we can put 25 men in each one. They said, but we're hungry. I said, yeah, well, I got a 10-man detail, all 6 feet tall. It's going to go back almost 5 miles with snowshoes to get us sea rations. I said, by 4 o'clock this afternoon, we'd have our igloos all built. Well, 4 o'clock, we were moving troops, 25 into each one of these igloos, and they were joined together. You could go from one to the other because we built them right close to one another. And the third one had 2 entranceways on it to go back into the first 2. And next morning, when we sounded reveille, everybody was dry. All their clothes was dry again. There's 75 men inside of about it. Not much more than 20 feet in diameter. You're close together and breathing inside of them. You get as hot as can be. But the detail they brought the sea rations back, it got back in right around 4 in the afternoon, so they had a full belly and they got a warm place to stay for the night. It worked out wonderful.